Aaron, why don't we kind of take this down level and then we'll just start scraping an inch or two at a time.
I'll just jump in the mini real quick.
So we're back here at the trike site. We took out that beautiful horn a few days ago. Oh, baby, life is great. Today, we're gonna take a little bit of the top of this off just in case there's any bones back here farther in.
After Mike, Aaron, and Jake found the Triceratops horn and frill, they were hopeful they were onto something big. But unfortunately, the site hasn't yielded anything more.
We're on a dry streak. We gotta start finding some bones.
Our site kinda has me a little worried here. The way the bones are scattered, they're spaced out pretty far. You know, pretty soon we're gonna have weather coming in. It's gonna get colder, might get shut out of this. How far are we gonna go here?
Gotta switch it up, do something. Uh-oh.
Boys, I hear your conversation.
Here comes the wizard.
Breaking out the sorcery, huh?
You bet. He was about ready to quit, so had to get out the witching wire. It's a kind of an old tradition. A lot of old cowboys, they witch for water.
The old wizard is back at it.
If you got any better ideas, let's do yours first.
Go ahead, it can't hurt.
Desperation breeds creativity.
I'm game.
All we do is we take an old steel coat hanger and we bend it. You let them float in your hands. You just let them float. You don't grab a hold of them. And for some odd reason, when they can pick up mineral, they cross, starting to do something.
Oh, the old wizard.
Right here, Aaron. Right underneath my feet. It's maybe a little bit of folklore, I don't know, but the proof's in the pudding.
He picks up VHF and UHF.
Using for a cell phone tower, right?
You ever seen such a thing, Aaron?
I've seen it. Ordinarily, I'd have my doubts about whether or not they work, but hell, we need something to work. I'm not gonna doubt it.
You guys laugh at me, you go right ahead and laugh.
Are you sure you're not getting a reading off the metal plate in your head?
You're funny, Jake.
All right, let's see if Pops was right.
Let's tear the lid off this thing.
There goes the X.
Just want to shave a little bit at a time, because I don't want to destroy a specimen. If I bust through a bone with this tooth bucket, we're going to have a 66-million-year-old puzzle to put back together. What's this right here? Right under my tooth.
Oh, oh, don't move.
I see something.
Yes, it is bone.
God, it is hard, man.
Terrible hard.
The ground where the bone is encased is a hard sedimentary rock called shale.
The further you get into the bank, the matrix is getting harder.
I brought down the pig, it's up there.
Shale is like this hard packed clay. It's been compacted over millions of years and it's like turned into concrete. Take the top off with the air chisel now. Choose your weapon.
The air chisels, the little pigs is what we call them. It's a little tiny jackhammer. That is essential. This stuff is just so hard. There's no other way we could dig it.
Oh, much easier. Comes off like butter.
You saw part of it back here?
Yeah. Right into there. A lot of iron on it.
You can do on the back side of that.
I gotta see it from the other side.
Can you watch underneath of it as you lift it?
Ooh, pretty hefty piece.
Aaron,
what you got there?
Take a look at this. What are you thinking?
What do you think it is?
Same thing you think it is.
This is a little baby horn.
This is a baby horn. There's a baby Triceratops, like a 3 foot tall little guy.
The youngest Triceratops fossil ever found was probably a yearling. Its brow horns, little one-inch nubs. So this Triceratops was probably 3 to 4 years old.
A baby tricorn. I've never seen one, and I don't know of anybody who has one.
It tapers down to a natural point. It's got blood grooves.
It's got blood grooves.
It's got pores.
Baby Triceratops horns weren't enough to defend against large predators. But parents likely protected their young well after hatching, which could account for this horn's proximity to the larger adult horn they found earlier.
Wow, this is a beauty of a find.
It's a valuable, rare fossil, but it could also mean a potential problem for the entire site.
This could be a Triceratops bone bed here.
This would be consistent with animals being out here sitting around waiting for water, they die. And then when water comes, other animals wade out in the water, crush the bones and push them down into the mud.
Finding the baby trichorn is a little bit of a curveball. It's a multiple animal site now.
More animals means more bones, which can be extremely lucrative. But it also means a much longer excavation, especially in this rocky shale.
If you have really hard matrix, you can just be in for a long haul to get anything out.
The team needs to assess whether this site is worth the effort to continue digging so late in the season.
Winter's creeping in, we're running out of time.
There's two races going on here. The race with the weather, and then there's the race with the dig. Depending on the sites you find, some of them take longer to dig than others.
And it's gonna be a longer dig here.
Then you're up against winter on the back end. Who knows when it's gonna start snowing again, and who knows when the ground's gonna freeze.
We're to the point where we're gonna have to abandon this site pretty soon and save it for another day.
You know, it's a kind of a downer because we're really getting into a groove here, and now we got to shut things down.
I think it's going to be a good thing to start back in the springtime when we can spend a lot more time.
We're losing time on another site.
I agree.
They'll walk away with multiple skull bones, including two beautiful horns. They're worth at least 25 grand, but they won't be sold until the site is completed.
I know we need to make a mortgage payment this fall, but this little jewel cannot be for sale unless you've got the whole animal, and then it would really be something. Good job, guys. Let's get this puppy to the lab.
We got her. Got a boy.
Arriba!
Let's get this thing in the lab. Now remember, I'm an old man. You ready?
After excavating an enormous Triceratops brow horn, Mike and Aaron are ready to start prep on the fossil, so it can be finished by Todd over the winter.
This is where we left all of the dirt in it before. We're gonna cut the edges of it down to where we can get the rest of the dirt out and try to stabilize the rest of this. You have to be careful not to get too low down and start to scraping the bone. How many fingers are you short by now? Got them all? This thing will be ready to go to Todd after a couple days and have him kind of look at what we got so he can give me an estimate of what we're getting into. Almost all fossils take an awful lot of lab hours, but when you see a fossil all prepped out, it looks like, wow, this is pretty cool. Todd will have this thing looking like a brand new bouquet of spring flowers.
Only dig till we hit bone and then we stop and move on. Well, this thing just wants to flake up bad. We use an adhesive called Vinac. It's a penetrant and stabilizer. It works into the bone and then solidifies the core of the bone so that when you try to handle it, it doesn't fall to pieces.
He's trying to hit these cracks.
We can get just enough to see the quality of what we got. It's one of the coolest feelings in the world to uncover a bone that we are the very first eyes of the human race to ever set on this piece. Actually, from the bottom side, I think there's a little more skull on it than what we thought.
Yeah, seeing it now.
It kind of lights a fire under you, kind of drives your thirst for more.
The only thing you're missing is the orbital.
That may show up as we get it cleaned off.
I'm not pushing my luck anymore.
Yeah,
here.
No, I think that's just perfect. We'll let Todd straighten it out.
This horn plus the other bones from the site could bring 25 grand. But if they find more bones next year, they could get a whole lot more. So it's worth the wait.
I think we hit a home run on this critter. All right, let's button her up. I'll clean up the mess tomorrow.
All right. Behind you.